All right, y'all. Let's do a ride along. Man, you know what? This is Texas, and you will really truly want to believe, which it is true, you would truly want to believe that, you know, Texas got all these super trucker-friendly streets, but as you see, in certain parts of Texas, Texas ain't that friendly with their turns or streets either. So, don't be always taking for granted that that Texas is super friendly when it comes to streets. You're gonna hit some of these sidewalks too. So, I just ran into another subscriber, and I'm giving you a shout out. I believe you say your name, Izel. Hey, Izel, nice to meet you. I hope you and your girlfriend drive safe. So nice to meet you once again. And you know, since you work for Prime, I'm hoping that you can help me out with information too, because you've been here a lot longer than I have. So keep up the good work, man. You're doing real good for yourself. But let's ride the streets of Texas. Shoot, I'm truly considering, probably no time soon, but I wouldn't mind living in Texas one day, because you know, it seems like there's a lot of great lows here in Texas. Texas is definitely trucker friendly when it comes to money. Sure, you get that bank, paper bank. Sure, you can be a local driver and still clean up, a company driver, local driver, lease driver. It just seems like Texas is trucker friendly when it comes to that. So yeah, man, let me show y'all the streets of Houston. It's Houston, Texas, H-Town, baby. Sure, H-Town was actually one of my favorite groups too, back in the day. It's a back in the day R&B group. H-Town, that's where I guess the state stomping ground. Good old H-Town.
In 0.2 miles, take the freeway entrance.
I just enjoy the ride.
Keep to the right at 0.4 miles. Just enjoy the view
of good old Houston, Texas. That's one good thing though about becoming an OTR driver. Like I said in one of my videos, you know, you get to see places that, in other words, you probably either would have probably took a long time to plan to see, or you probably never would have saw. So, I mean, I've been to Texas before, of course, for delivering my loads. But other than that, before I came to Prime, I've never been to no Houston, Texas. So, I mean, it seems pretty down here, nice and clean. You can't beat it. So, I mean, you can't beat it. Today seems like a better day as far as weather, so hopefully we won't be riding past no accidents or anything. Hopefully this will be a better day.
600 feet, take the freeway entrance on.
I ain't only got one more stop, so after this stop, hopefully I get reloaded quicker. But I still got, you know, enough time to turn something. So, you know, when it's, like, say you about to get to your 90 that day. And like in my instance, I'm only like a few miles away, so it's not going to take my whole clock to do a few miles. So you want to try to you know, get in contact with your dispatcher to let him know, hey, I'm ready to reload, you know, could you please reload me in a timely fashion? Because I mean, it really depends on dispatches. Depending on what dispatcher you got, you know, sometimes you be sitting longer than you would like. So, I mean, just as much as they hassle you about things, sure, you got every right, not to say hassle, but you got every right to consult them about what's going on with the timely manner of your load according to your clocks, because obviously clocks do tick down. So if you got darn near a 4 o'clock, you want to make full use of all those hours you got to make money. That's the whole purpose of a clock, is for you to make money off of it, not to just sit. Because, you know, if your wheels ain't rolling, you ain't making no money. And that's the whole purpose that we're even out here, is to get paid, right? So build that A1 relationship with your dispatcher so y'all can be on one accord and, you know, understand your logs and understand that you out here to get paid just like he's in that office to get paid. So don't be, my thing is, and it seems like a lot of company drivers, and I could, you know, really it's not everybody, but it's probably more than enough, but a lot of company drivers seem to fall victim to, well, you know, I don't really want to say much because I'm scared if I say something, he might not give me the miles or he might not give me the loads that I need to make money. Sure, but believe it or not, that's the total opposite, because when you prove to your dispatcher that you are a pushover, then guess what he's gonna do? He's gonna push you over. So just as much as they try to stay firm with you on how you run your loads or what you need to do this and do that, like I said, you have every right to give back that same firmness about what you expect as far as you being out here to make a living. So, I mean, there's no bars hold when it comes to your money. Sure, this is not to say a super hard job, but this job has a lot of sacrifices. So I will hope that people are not out here sacrificing for nothing. So the fact that you sacrificing life, your home life, and all kind of comfortabilities of your life, you know, you need to be putting your foot on your dispatcher's neck to let them know, show me some respect when it comes to, you know, me getting the proper loads that I need, either as a lease driver to run my business and my home, or as a company driver just to make a nice, decent paycheck. That's what I am out here for. Not out here for nothing else. I'm not out here to be pushed over. I'm not out here just to make the company money. I'm out here to make the company money and myself as well. This is supposed to be, you know, a team effort, so, yeah. But today, definitely, I promise, because I feel quite rested, and when I come to a stop, I'm definitely going to get live. Only way I won't do a live is something happened, like the traffic situation yesterday. But today looked like it's going to be a pretty decent day, so it's looking like when I come to a stop that I should be able to go live with you guys. So just bear with me, guys. Bear with me. And I'll probably do another minute or two of this ride along and then, you know, get back with y'all later. Enjoy a little bit of Fuji's with me for a little bit while we ride. I don't know who listened to what or what, but obviously there's different ears listening on my YouTube channel, but you know, I'm pretty much like a R&B, jazz, hip-hop, you know, I like some rock and roll songs are pretty decent, but my main thing that is like mainly what I listen to is mainly like jazzy, slow jams, and some rap, but I'm mainly on like the slow R&B side of everything. So
Refuge.
give y'all one more song and then I'll cut it off. So I don't know what you're gonna play.
Listen, you gotta put me on, put me on.
Did I leave your mind when I was gone?
Ain't nothing like hip-hop music.
Well, this time I think trying to get back.
Listen, you gotta put me on, put me on.
This time let me tell you where I'm at.
What's up, baby?
I don't wanna be where you are.
Put the face into this.
Everywhere you are.
Can I get it so
tight? I gotta be where you are.
Everybody got a brother that rap, a sister that sing, a cousin that sling, a uncle upstate, time in the bay, beef on the block, war with the cops, farmers with crops, shovels in their hands, screaming legalize the beat and toss. They even got hip-hop cops, follow me red dot, keep a camcorder just in case they want to frame the author. Caught you off guard, this verse is unexpected. Listen, like when I rhymed on Big Punch Records.
I got a swagger, I cut any rapper, mind over matter, lyrical dagger, like alcohol, I'm back for your liver, quiver, shiver, body temperature, get found in Hudson River.
Deliver a message to your mom, you won't be coming
home. You know, becomes the gunner becomes the hunter becomes the hundred on America's most wanted.
Yeah. I reminisce, had no cash for tomorrow, but excited tonight, cause we the open and
act for the you are.
You gotta put me
everywhere
on, put me
you are.
Can I get it so
tight? I gotta be where you are.
Can I get it so tight?
Everywhere you are.
We entered into hip-hop, we were young, gifted and boundless, attracted to the freedom, the courage, power, profoundness. We had our pretensions, dissensions, conventions, but there was room to learn that we were open to the challenge. But then came the fame, money, notoriety, hypocrisy, then anxiety. Most of us suffered quietly from PR to ER. When freedom got detoured, truth turned to folklore, the youth turned to cold war. Escape from reality, afraid of exposure, pride, deny closure, did what they told you. Agendas and egos began to live through us. They started to take what they were supposed to give to us. Distorted dynamics, making egos gigantic. Emotional artists got bought, soldiers and damaged. Black disadvantage, no fact, acts mismanaged. Bad contracts and standards take land back to man.
Everywhere you are,
you gotta put me
everywhere
on, put me
everywhere
on.
You are,
can I get it so
tight? I gotta be where you are.
Can I get it so tight?
Everywhere you are.
Yo, it's the most blunted, yeah, the most wanted. House of Gucci, stay the most haunted. Guys and dolls, jump right on it. 10 years later, it ain't ironic. Straight 16s, up the screen. Triple B, like Sinatra, Davis and Dean. Everything in between, if you know what I mean. Wanna be with you all, it's American dream. But I was often told, I was off my road. Never sold my soul for the glitter of gold. Let the truth be told, I made the mold. 23 years old, 20 million sold. Classic man, like spaghetti western. Black baby style, always Texan. Bombing up the dial from master flexing. It's the world hip hop. Keep guessing.
I wanna be, ooh. I gotta be where you are. I gotta be gay.
Try your tears, I say. until my peeps passed away.
No one
for pain of losing family. But while I'm gone, shorty, everything is gonna be alright. Everything is gonna be alright. Fuji's come to the dance tonight. But everything is gonna be alright. Everything is gonna be alright. Oh, everything is gonna be alright. The gunman's in the house tonight. But everything is gonna be alright.
Y'all, I'll be back. Yeah.